Hi students, this is Krishna, Zoology, Kartya Junior College. So, now I am taking the first topic in the first year class, Protozoa, Locomotion and Reproduction. So, this is the fifth unit. The weightage in IP is 8 marks. 8 marks. So, 1 4 marks question. And the 2 marks question. Total 8 marks in weighted in IPE examination. So now protozoa, locomotion and reproduction. So we will discuss about what is mean protozoa. The protozoa means proto means first, zoa means animals. Total first animals on the earth. So that first animals locomotion and reproduction, so reveals in the unit. So this is about the protozoa locomotion. So the protozoa is, so this is the well-known name in the previous, already we learned about the previous classes. So that is about the protozoa. So now, what is mean locomotion? So the locomotion means moving. So moving means, so one organism moves from one place to another place. So that is called as locomotion. So the locomotion means an organism moves from one place to another place, is called as locomotion. So here the protozoa organisms moving from one to another place. So why an organism moves from one to another place? So an organism moving for four needs. One is food, and another one shelter, and another one escaping from predators, and self protection, and another one search sex mate. For these four needs, an organism moved to another place. So for this, the all animals are heterotrophs, compulsory depending on autotrophs and other animals. Hence, the organism moves from one to another place. So every animal is having the shelter. So the native place, habitat, his needs. So hence, so the searching, the shelter, and another one self-protection. So the organism escaping from their predators, and another one search for sex mate. So this is the four needs for an organism moves from one to another place. So now we discuss about the characters of protozoa. So the protozoa animals are asexual. Protozoa animals are unicellular animals and microscopic organism. Acellular means the protozoa organisms are body organized by single cell. So that is acellular or unicellular organism. Next, microscopic. So this is very microscopic organisms, and we can see only under the electronic microscope only. So this is the microscopic organisms. And so the protozoa organisms performs and moves locomotion by versatile locomotion. So the aquatic protozoans are moves through the water. Aquatic protozoans moves through water waves, and parasitic protozoans. So which is most of the body fluids in the host. So this is about the protozoa. So the protozoa locomotion is assisted by four locomotor organelles. The protozoa animals performed by four type of locomotor organelle, which is pseudopodia. Pseudopodia. And another one is flagella. Flagella. And another one is cilia. And another one is myelids. Myelids. So these four types of locomotor organelles involving the protozoa locomotion. So the pseudopodia is, this is the cellular extension, and the flagella is whip-like structure, and the cilia is short hair-like structure, and this is the contractile fibrous tubes. So this is the four types of locomotor organelles. Now we discuss about first the pseudopodias. So the pseudopodia organelles, locomotor organelles present in the protozoa, rhizopoda, this is the class in the protozoa phylum. So the pseudopodia meaning, so this is the cellular extension of cytoplasm. So that is cellular extension of cytoplasm. So that is develop the movement of the substratum. So that is called as pseudopodia. For example, amoeba. So amoeba is structureless organism. So this is the single cellular organism. So this is the plasma membrane and the nucleus. So other cellular organelles are there. So this is the cytoplasm. So which is cellular extensions? So the definition of pseudopodia is extend. So the extending of cytoplasm. So this is the portini, extending of cytoplasm. So that is develops movement. So these newly formed structures, so makes movement on the substratum, help the locomotion on the substratum like our legs. So this is called as pseudopodia. Pseudopodia. And once again, pseudopodia means, so cellular extension, that is develops the movement on the substratum. So this is called as pseudopodia. So the pseudopodia is classified into four types by structures. Classified into four types. Number one, lobopodia. And another one, Philopodia. And another one, Reticulopodia. And another one, Oxopodia. So this is the classifying of four types. Number one, Lobopodia. Here, podia means speech. Lobo means blunt. So totally lobopodia means blunt finger like structure. So this locomotor organelle is called as lobopodia. Example amoeba. So this is the amoeba. So which is look like a blunt finger like structure. So here we have to see clarity. So clear. So this look like a blunt finger like. So these blunt finger like organelles are involved in the locomotion on the substratum. So this is about the lobopodia. Next one, Phyllopodia. Phyllopodia means fibre like structure. Fibre means thread. Thread like structure. So example organism is Euglypha. Euglypha. Euglypha, this is the marine organism. Marine organism. So this is the locomotor organelles. So it's look like a thread like structure. So which is called is Phyllopodia, which is involving the locomotion. Next, Reticulopodia. Reticulopodia, it's look like net like structure. Net like structure. Example, Elpidium. Example, Elpidium. So this is the Elpidium. Elpidium, this is the net like structure which is involved in the movement. This is called Reticulopodia. Next one, Oxopodia. Oxopodia means sun rays like structure. So example organism is Ectinopris. So Ectinopris, so this is the sun ray like structure. So which is the involving the locomotion. This is about the Oxopodia. Here Pseudopodia and the classification 4 marks important in IPE. Pseudopodia means this is the cellular extension of cytoplasm that develops the locomotion, that is called is Pseudopodia. And classified 4 types, Lobopodia. So it's look like blunt finger like structure. This is called is Lobopodia. Example amoeba. And Phyllopodia is fibre and thread like structure. Example is Euglypha. And Reticulopodia, net like structure. This is called, example is Elpidium. And Oxopodia means sunray like structure. So this is example the Ectinopris. So this is about the Pseudopodia. Next one, Pseudopodia. Next one, Flagella. Flagella. So the flagella is one of the locomotor organelle in the protozoa. So the structure of flagella is long whip like structure. So long whip like structure locomotor organelle are called flagella. So it is long whip like structure. So this is about the flagella. So the flagella is, so in the bacterium, so having the, which is locomotion through the flagella, and also human sperm having the flagella locomotion. So this is about the flagella. So the flagella is classifying several types, which is depending on the lateral appendages. So number one, Stychonematic. And another one, Pantonematic. And third one, Acronematic. Fourth one, Pantochronematic. And fifth one, Acronematic, Enigmatic, or Simple, Enigmatic or Simple. Flagella, a long whip like structure. This is classified into 5 types depending on which classification depending on present and the options of number of rows of lateral appendages on the axoning. So which is classified 5 types. So number of 1 or 2 or more rows of lateral appendages. So here we have to see the axonemy having the two rows. So here like a number of rows of lateral appendages. So that is depending on the 5 types. So here this is base of flagella. It is called basal granule. Basal granule. So here middle thick part. This is called axoning. Axoning. So which is lateral? Short ear like structure. This is called lateral appendages. Lateral. Appendages. So lateral means sides here. So depending on the 5 types, lateral appendages definition is 1 or 2 or more rows of short hair-like structure which is present on the axonium is called as lateral appendages and also called as mastogonies. Mastogonies. So this is about the lateral appendages. Next, first type, stygonimatic. So these type of flagella having only one row of lateral appendages. So this is the basal granule axoning. Only one row of lateral appendages present on the axoning. The stygonimatic flagella bears only one row. Lateral appendages present on the axoning. So this type of flagella are called is stygonimatic. Example, Euglena. So you well known organism Euglena. So Euglena structure, this is like, so this, if it is Euglena, so this is the flagella. This flagella having only one row lateral appendages. Next one, phantognematic flagella. So phantognematic flagella means the flagella bears 1 or 2 or more rows of lateral appendages are present in the axonium. Here we have to see, so more than 2 rows are present. So these like flagella are called as phantognematic. Example organism is Perinema. Perinema. So this is the example Perinema. Next one, acronematic. Acronematic means, so the flagella absence of lateral appendages, so but tip of terminal part is naked. Terminal part is naked. So here we have to see clearly. So if you hear, lateral appendages are absent. So the terminal means tip of. So top of the flagella. So naked. So naked means, so any sheet cover tip of terminal part of the flagella. Hence it is naked. So this like is called is acronematic. Acronematic example organism is Chlamydomonas. Chlamydomonas. So next one, phantochromatic. Phantochromatic example, phantochromatic meaning is, so the flagella bears 2 or more rows of lateral appendages present, but terminal part is naked. Terminal part is naked. So this like flagella are called is phantochromatic. Example is osceolus. Osceolus. So next one, enigmatic or simple type of flagella. So this flagella bears lateral appendages are absent and terminal part is absent. Lateral appendages are absent, terminal part is absent. So this is called as enigmatic. Example is Chylomonas. Chylomonas. So this is the 4 marks important question. So what is mean lateral appendages and class, describe the classification of flagella. So steichoenigmatic mean only one row of lateral appendages present. Phantoenigmatic mean more than 2 rows are present. Acroenigmatic mean lateral appendages are absent, terminal pod is naked. And pantochromatic, more than 2 rows of lateral appendages present, terminal pod is naked. Simple means lateral appendages are absent and terminal pod is absent. So the classification of flagella.